very good morning to all. Myself, Khushbu Balodia, Assistant Professor, Chemical Engineering Department, LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology. My subject is Green Technology and Sustainable Development. This subject is very first time introduced by JTU. We will see the meaning of this two term, Green Technology and Sustainable Development. Now, Green Technology, that means development of technology, use of technology in a such a way that it does not harm to our environment, human being, as well as our natural resources. So, developed a product and process in a such a way that it should have minimum environmental impact. Another term is the sustainable development. Sustainable development, that means meeting the needs of present, without damaging the future requirement. That means without damaging the future generation's ability to meet their own requirement. Right? Now, how this green concept comes into existence? So, why this green concept comes into existence? Natural resources. We have many natural resources available, like water, land, trees, pure air. But what we have done with them? A lots of activities is done by human being to meet their own requirement, to meet their future requirement, without think of environment, without think of natural resources. So many things are happening nowadays, like for deforestation, global warming, soil degradation, right? Natural disasters taking place. Recently, India faced a problem like Uttarakhand glacier burst, right? So lots of things are happening with us. So by this way, green technology or green engineering word comes into a picture. So we will see detail what is green technology. It is a technology which is environmentally friendly, developed and used in a such a way that so that it does not disturb our environment and conserve natural resources. Now see the meaning, that develop technology which is environmental friendly and use that technology in a such a way that it does not disturb our environment as well as it conserve the natural resources. So ultimately, development of green technology leads towards the sustainable development, or I can say sustainable technology. So sustainable technology, here I mean improving our social and environmental footprint at every stage of the product life, starting with the raw material to the end life of the product. Right? In a sustainable development or in a sustainable technology, we are not only thinking about the process of any component or process of any product, right? But also we are thinking of starting of the raw material to the end process or to the end part of the our product. So a developed a product or process in a such a way that it should be environmental friendly or having a less environmental impact, starting with the selection of raw material to the end life of the product. Now we have aims of green technology. We have total four aims of green technology. One aim is it minimize the deterioration of environment. Another aim is it enhance the utilization of renewable sources. Another is it saves the natural resources. And another goal is it lowers greenhouse gas emission and enhance healthy and improved environment for all form of life. So to achieve all this aim, right, certain researches are going on. So we have next is examples of green technology. Nowadays, lots of inventions are taking place towards the direction of green technology, green engineering. So here I am describing some of the examples of green technology. One very good example of green technology is LED lighting. Right? What are the advantages of LED lighting compared to conventional bulb system or compared to conventional light is, one is it increases efficiency, that means it will lower down the energy requirement. right? So our electric consumption will be lower in LED lighting. Another advantage is it's bright, right? It will give you more emission. And third advantage as compared to conventional lighting is, in a conventional lighting there is a use of mercury, and mercury is very hazardous to human health as well as environmental life. So this LED lighting by this way is a beautiful example of a green technology. Another example of green technology is electric vehicle. Electric vehicle definitely use the electric energy, right, to drive the vehicle. In a conventional vehicles we are using fossil fuels, or I can say petroleum based product, right? So it will increase your environmental pollutant, or it will cause your environmental pollution. So another options available is electric vehicle, right? It will have a lesser environmental impact. Next example is vertical farming. That is also a nowadays emerging concept. Another is wind energy. Yes, to achieve the green technology, try to use as much as possible natural resources, or I can say renewable resources. So wind energy is also a good example of green technology, because nowadays we can generate tremendous amount of electricity by using the wind energy. Another is elimination of industrial emission, but obvious, all these industrial emissions are very hazardous, very toxic in nature, so control that industrial emission. Another is wastewater treatment, because this wastewater that we are discarding simply into river or sea, that affect our aquatic life. So treatment of wastewater also is a green technology. Another is the solar panel. Nowadays use of solar energy is also increasing, so solar panels are used in various buildings to generate their electricity requirement. Now we have a different types of green technology. So first type of green technology is green chemistry. Green chemistry, that also known as a sustainable chemistry, and we will see for this subject green chemistry in detail. Green chemistry, as I said earlier, it's a sustainable chemistry which says that developed a product, a chemical product or process in a such a way that it should be non-hazardous, it should have a less waste generation, moreover that efficiency is very high. So ultimately it says that develop a product in a such a way that there should be a less harmful impact, right? Another type of green technology is green nanotechnology. That means the use of nanotechnology in combination with green technology. That means use nanotechnology in a such a way that it should have a less environmental impact along with reduction in cost, right? Because by using nanotechnology we can achieve many good advantages. So for example, reduction in cost, increase in efficiency, product recoverability, reusability, and all these things, right? So use the nanotechnology in a such a way that you can generate your own requirement without harmful effect on our natural resources, or without any harmful impact on our society. Another type of green technology is a green building. Green building not only says that construction of building. Green building, that means starting with the selection of site, starting with the selection of raw material, develop a building in a such a way that throughout the entire life of building, it conserves our natural resources, it does not have any harmful impact on the society. That means select a site, select a raw material in a such a way that at the end life of that building, it does not create any harmful impact. Another type of green technology is green information technology. Green information technology, earlier I means green computing. Green computing, that means starting with the manufacturing, to the use, to the electricity requirement, and to the final end life. End life, that means when we discard our electric items, or when we discard our computing system. So develop our computing system or information technology in a such a way that it should generate a lower hazardous waste, or particularly I can say electronic waste. Or develop your computer in a such a way that it will lower down the energy consumption, as well as the product life is very high, and as well as think of the treatment after waste is generated. So that is all deal with the green information technology. And last type of green technology is the green energy. Green energy, that means use of natural resources, use of renewable resources as much as possible. Example of green energy is solar energy, wind energy, geothermal energy, biomass, right? All these are the examples of green energy. Here green energy doesn't mean that use of all the renewable resources or natural resources to generate the electricity requirement or to meet the energy requirement. Say for example, I am saying to generate the electricity, someone is using fossil fuel, right? And that fossil fuel is burning to generate that electricity. But what is the disadvantage or what is the problem in that? Because it generates air pollution, right? So this is not the green energy. Green energy, that means use the renewable source or natural resources by eliminating the environmental impact, by eliminating the reduction on load of environment. So these all are the types of green technology, right? We will see detail about the green chemistry in detail. Some others example of green technology also I would like to give you, some recent technologies that is inventing. One is the solar glass. Solar glass, that means the glass itself having the ability to generate the electricity and store that electricity, right? So nowadays that is also a becoming a most promising concept. Another thing is a solar building, right? Or I can say vertical farming also is a good example of green technology. Another example of green technology is a sea beam. Sea beam, that means that clears the sea, right? Because nowadays too much things are ultimately going to our sea, and that ultimately affect our aquatic life, right? So that sea beams control all the pollutions or all the components that is harmful to our aquatic culture or aquatic life, right? Another thing is the intelligent bucket. Yes, intelligent bucket, that means growing a plant in a desert area. So this is also a possible by using the concept of intelligent bucket. What actually is there in intelligent bucket, that means it bucket itself is made up of renewable material or renewable paper material, and that bucket itself germinates the seeds, right? So by in this intelligent bucket concept, there is a reduction of 90% water requirement. Right. So in this you can use those concept in the desert area also. So many technologies nowadays are developing towards the green concept, because we are impacting our environment, right, very harmfully. So this was regarding the today's session about the green technology and sustainable development. We will see the concept of green chemistry along with the 12 principle of green chemistry with example in detail with the new video lectures. So this was regarding the today's session. Let's go green. Thank you so much.